Hi there, Doug Stinwin with IT Creations with a compact edge server, the Dell PowerEdge XR4000 series with PowerEdge XR4510c and XR4520c sleds. There are two versions of the chassis, the XR4000r and the XR4000z. One is rack-mountable and the other can be stacked like Tupperware or even bolted to the wall or ceiling. Both support the same server sleds, which provides the compute for the platform. Like our channel? Hit that subscribe button. Need a little more time on that critical decision? Then let's get to it. The PowerEdge XR4000r is the rack-mountable version and can support up to four PowerEdge XR4510c server sleds. The XR4000z can support two PowerEdge XR4510c server sleds. Also in the mix is the XR4520c, which offers a nearly 2U height. That one also has two PCIe slots for additional storage, networking cards, or even GPUs. There's also a witness sled, the XR4000W, but we'll get to that. What are these platforms good for? Well, it is an edge server and provides high-performance compute and flexibility to deploy just about anywhere. It can also be used for virtual desktop integration, machine vision, video surveillance, as a virtual storage area network or virtual machine, even for point-of-sale, an IoT appliance, and data compression. Of course, Dell also says this platform can be used for AI and machine learning. That machine vision aspect is for image-based automatic inspection and analysis in industrial applications for quality control and automation. Let's start with the XR4000R. This one is like a standard rack server at 2U, just less depth than average. That depth will also be affected if you install the optional bezel, which does look pretty nice and offers a filter for dusty environments. There are no external storage bays on this system, only internal NVMe M.2 drives, which we will get to. Server sleds slide in from the front of the chassis. The basic configuration includes dual redundant PSUs on the right, with a slot for a witness sled adjacent to that. There are a few different options for the PSUs on the system. You can install either up to four XR4510C server sleds, up to two XR4520C server sleds, or a combination of the two. Maybe two XR4510C server sleds with a single XR4520C double height sled. Blanks are available. Front ports are from the XR4510C or XR4520C server sleds. Are you interested in the Dell PowerEdge XR4000 system? Either the rack-mountable XR4000R or maybe that sleek little XR4000Z stackable and wall-ceiling mountable chassis? You know, with the associated server sleds. If you are, then for a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system that's listed or one that you can configure that's valued at $5,000 or more. Click that link for more information. When you're ready to make a purchase, just mention this video. Maybe we'll even throw in some of those ho-hos or pez or something. Who knows? The XR4000Z, on the other hand, is much more compact for positioning in areas without a dedicated server room or server rack for that matter. You can stack it like Legos or mount it to the wall or ceiling. Neither the XR4000Z or XR4000R support compute without the server sleds, just power, a chassis manager, and a witness sled fan module. It's not as wide as the XR4000R because it only fits two of the small XR4510C sleds or just one of the XR4520C sleds with the additional PCIe slots. The front of the PowerEdge XR4510C server sled features an iDRAC direct port to access the integrated management module. Next, a power on button, a sled release tab at the bottom, and then a mini display port with a dedicated RJ45 iDRAC management port right beside that. Then two USB ports and a serial port. Above all of that, there are four SFP ports offering either 25 gigabit Ethernet or 10 gigabit Ethernet for network connectivity. The XR4520C is set up the same way in the bottom portion of the sled, but offers two PCIe slots above for networking cards, additional storage, or GPUs. It's also designed to withstand harsh temperature variations. Not much to see on the back unless you plan to route the PSU power cables through the back of the system. Otherwise, there is a plate to cover that up and a perforated panel across the back of the chassis for airflow. That other little module right beside the PSUs is the XR4000W witness sled. It has a power on button on top, USB serial port, USB port, and two RJ45 ports with sled release button on the bottom. It's powered by a single Intel Atom C3508 processor with four cores, plus 16 gigabytes of memory and one M.2 drive. The witness sled cannot be modified to support additional processors or memory. What the witness sled is used for is virtual desktop infrastructure, virtual storage area networks, and virtual machines. If there are two compute modules installed in a cluster, the witness sled will be the deciding factor when there are inconsistencies in the data between the nodes. In a nutshell, it acts as a dedicated node to monitor the cluster and resolve conflicts. It's optional and primarily used for VMware vSAN environments. Yeah, think about it as that angel and devil on your shoulder, knowing that you have to make the final decision. The XR4510c compute module is a nearly 1U height server sled. Once we pull it out of the chassis, you can see the single socket for the third generation Intel Xeon D scalable processor with up to 20 cores and three fan modules at the back pulling air through the chassis and out the back. There are four DDR4 DIMM slots. It can accommodate up to 256 gigabytes of registered DIMMs or up to 512 gigabytes of load reduced DIMMs. For storage, the system has an M.2 riser module that can be outfitted with up to four NVMe M.2 SSDs. In addition, the system can be outfitted with an optional Dell boot optimized storage system or BOSS N1 to boot the system. With two drives, they can be mirrored in a hardware RAID 1 configuration for redundancy. For management of this system, there's iDRAC 9, also known as the Integrated Dell Remote Access Controller, and the Dell Open Managed Suite of Tools. By the way, I did do a short video on iDRAC 9 Enterprise a little while ago, and you can see it here. iDRAC does allow for remote access of the system for management, troubleshooting, and inventory. This one comes with iDRAC Direct. With Open Manage, you also get a Power Manager plugin, plus Service and Update Manager plugins. There is also a number of other utilities for use with third-party applications. Now the other sled, the PowerEdge XR4520C, is nearly 2U in height to accommodate all the same stuff I just mentioned. Third-gen Intel Xeon D scalable CPU, up to 512 gigabytes of DDR4 memory, but also six fans and two PCIe Gen 4 full-height, full-length slots. Those slots can be used to support up to eight more NVMe M.2 SSDs. That would be in addition to the four NVMe M.2 SSDs on the riser module. It can also be used for additional network controllers with faster data rates. Also, two single-width 150-watt GPUs or a single 250-watt double-width GPU. Given those wattages, there are a number of GPU options available that could definitely be useful in this system. But Dell only mentions the NVIDIA A2 and NVIDIA A30. Both of those come with some thermal restrictions. The NVIDIA A30 is a double-width professional graphics card with 24 gigabytes of HBM2E memory. With the double-wide card, you can install only one of those in the XR4520C compute sled. It features Ampere architecture, a TDP of 165 watts, and is designed for AI inference at scale and high-performance computing applications. It also supports MIG, or multi-instance GPUs, which allows you to distribute the GPU memory to up to four different instances at 6 gigabytes of HBM2E memory each. It's great for a number of applications. The A30 does need additional power through an 8-pin power connector. On the other hand, the NVIDIA A2 GPU offers 16 gigabytes of GDDR6 memory and features Ampere architecture too. This is a single wide card, so you can install up to two of those, and it doesn't require additional power at only 60 watts power draw. Up to 75 watts of power can be supplied by the PCIe slot. Aside from the difference in memory capacity, there is also a difference in memory type between the two. The A2 has GDDR6 memory, while the A30 is outfitted with HBM2E memory. GDDR6 memory is used mostly in gaming cards and graphic-intensive applications. HBM2E memory is better for AI and high-performance computing. That said, neither of these cards have any monitor outputs, but the A2 does support DirectX 12 Ultimate, while the A30 does not support DirectX anything. And that is the Dell PowerEdge XR4000 series in a nutshell. Designed for a number of applications at the edge, it definitely provides some flexibility to support a number of applications depending on how it's configured. And with the PowerEdge XR4520C compute sled, even more options with the additional PCIe slots to add more storage, networking, or GPU computational power. If you like this video, consider subscribing. If you want more information on this server and the various compute sleds, check out IT Creations using a link I placed below or that one right there. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations. Thanks for watching.